So here today with Michael Bridges, who is running for state rep in the 37th district. How are you today?
I'm doing very well. Yourself?
Great. Thank you so much for doing this. Can you tell us why you decided to run for state rep?
Yes. I've served on the city council in Farmington Hills for 12 years, and I've learned a lot about local government, how it operates, and I also have experienced the fact that state government has a lot to do with local government. And I believe I have the experience, the values, and the commitment and dedication to do an effective job in Lansing. Just to give you more background on that, to help crystallize why I'm a candidate for public office, my interest in public service began some 40 years ago when I was a young guy in college. I had a class called career planning. In that class, we had to do a lifeline, which is to map out your life and your so I was 19 years of age, wrote down my goals, my short-term, intermediate, long-term goals. My short-term goals was to get a associate's degree, to get a bachelor's degree, to get married, to have children, and be a professional. And then, my last goal 40 years ago was to be a public official, to be a public servant. So that shows you my commitment and dedication to this is based on long-term commitment to public service.
So you have been serving on the council for 12 years. What are some of the things that you're most proud of?
I am most proud of the fact that we have a great city in Farmington Hills. We are the most diverse community in Oakland County. We are a safe city. We've been recognized as a safe city for several years in a row. We have a AAA bond rating, so we are fiscally responsible. We are known to be a well-run city. I'm also proud of the fact the city is a diverse community, whereas I'm proud of the fact that the role I played from standpoint of inclusion and diversity in our community. One of the things I noticed when I got on council that we needed to have more diversity in our workforce and our boards and commission. So I took upon myself as to represent that particular point of view, and we've made progress. We're not there yet, but we're making progress in regards to having a representative community regarding our workforce.
Now, if you are elected to state rep, what are some of the issues that you want to work on?
Well, as you know, everything has changed since COVID took place. Everything has changed dramatically. And I had an opportunity to listen in on a webinar with the Citizens Research Council. This is a nonpartisan group that well-respected in regards to public policy issue, research data. And I got a glimpse of what the state's finances are right now, and given the fact that expectations in regards to state finances going forward, particularly the state budget as well as the school aid fund. So I think that'll be the number one issue facing the incoming legislators to make sure that we address the issue regarding the impact of COVID-19 on state finances. And so I think that's a very important issue. Secondly, I believe strongly that public education has to be a top priority in our state. I believe that a funding priority for publication should be one of our number one goals. We have to find ways to bring more dollars to at-risk districts and also at-risk students. And I believe strongly we should definitely find more dollars that way, more tax dollars. Secondly, find more dollars for special education students and deal with some of the drawbacks of Proposal A. It definitely has had an impact on school financing. And I believe strongly that we need to look at ways to maybe tweak that a little bit, make sure that it's representative of today's society and economy.
So in addition to your public service positions, what's some of the professional background that you bring to the table?
Well, I have a bachelor's degree in business administration. I've been president of a chamber of commerce before. I've served on Economic Development Corporation. I have a bachelor's in business administration, so I'm very familiar with how finances work regarding debits and credits and expenses and revenue. So I bring that type of background to this. At the same time, bring a humanistic quality as well, concerned about the working man and working people in our state.
So along those lines, what are some of the ways you've been involved in the community beyond those roles?
Well, I've served on a number of boards and commissions in my community. I first got involved, moved to Farmington Hills in 1998. My wife and I, we moved to Farmington Hills. We had young children at the time, and we wanted to find a community that was diverse as well as having good public schools. And I also, again, given the fact I believe in public service and community service, I started serving on various boards and commissions. I served on my Homeowners Association Board of Directors. I served on the YMCA Board of Directors. I was the PTA Council Legislative Liaison for a number of years. Also, I was involved in my my son's youth football program as a Board of Directors member there. I've been involved in a number of areas in, across the city. Currently, I am the delegate, actually the council delegate for the Southeast Michigan Council of Governments. I'm also the liaison for our Farmington Area Aging Commission as well.
So in this race, you will have some competition in the primary. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, that's a good question, but I think the voters should pick me because I'm an experienced person, I'm a serious person. I am also a competent person. I have demonstrated in my job on city council, I can work on with all types of people. The council colleagues of mine have appointed me mayor pro tem twice in my tenure. And that's an indication that I get support from both sides of the aisle of Farmington City Council, here also City Council. I'll go to Lansing with a serious mind toward being substantive. I would listen to all sides. I will be an evidence-based person. Make decisions, I think, based on evidence and research. I will ask critical questions regarding any type of policy deliberation I may be involved in. I have real life experiences. I've been unemployed, and I know what that's like to be unemployed. I know how it's difficult sometimes for people to meet their daily expenses. And I have an understanding regarding small businesses. I know small businesses in our any community is very important. And I will be a supporter of small businesses in our state. I just think I have the values and experience and the commitment, dedication to be an effective legislator in Lansing.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Yes, they can go to my website, electmikebridges.com. That's electmikebridges.com. And my biography is there. There's also some position statements on some issues that I feel very strongly about. But they can go to that website, electmikebridges.com.
Great. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview today.
Crystal, I really appreciate it. I very look forward to further discussions, but thank you for the opportunity to talk to me. Appreciate it.